हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ नरेंद्र काटीकर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द डिटेल एक्सप्लेनेशन प्रेजेंटेशन अबाउट कॉम्प्रेशन मोल्डिंग. एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन द स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टूड the process and application of plastic compression molding process. The flow of the contents are as follows: introduction, plastic compression molding process, the polymers commonly used for compression molding, advantages for the respective process along with the disadvantage and prominent applications of the particular compression molding. Initially, let us see, before proceeding with one of the important plastic part manufacturing, that is compression molding, we have to discuss on plastic material. As we are aware, the plastic material is one of the prominent non-metal which is nowadays used for domestic as well as technical parts applications. This is just because of particularly the advantageous properties of the plastic material. Before proceeding with the important plastic part manufacturing process, that is compression molding, let us discuss on the plastic material, need of plastic material products, and in general plastic part manufacturing. Initially, as we know, we have to see the importance of the plastic material. As we are aware, this is one of the important non-metal used for various domestic as well as technical applications. This is just because of the particular important properties which behaves and shows by the plastic material, like anti-magnetic properties, like less weight to volume ratio, and many more. For example, the better particular applications also required the bad conductor of electricity. For such applications also, the plastic material is majorly used. The prominent important property of the plastic material, that is, it can be easily moldable at low temperature and it can be converted into the intricate size, shape and geometry also. As we are aware, almost the every metal is nowadays trying to be replaced by the plastic material. This is just to particularly fulfillment of whatever the plastic material product which should be behave as the same behavioral characteristics as that of metallic material part. Before proceeding with the compression molding, let us see that how the plastic part manufacturing process can be selected. Considering the geometry, rather overall specifications of the parts, as well as the allied things, that is the precision or accuracy required, the particular production rate and the quantity at which the product has to be manufactured, all these parameters are affecting on the selection of plastic part manufacturing method. Now let us proceed with the exact plastic compression molding process. You can have a look at and the screen where the three stages are self diagram explanation is there. The first diagram shows the loading of the charge, where normally the particular lower mold half is already heated or it is ongoing heating condition as per the requirements. The lower mold half carries the particular cavity and which is exactly the outer replica of product to be produced, in which the charge is nothing but the plastic raw material is to be feed over there. This plastic material may be in different form, like powder form, in granules form, in particular some of the cases the sheet or the pieces form also. Thus, the dry or plastic state charge is going to be fed into the lower mold half. And after a specific duration of time, that particular raw material is going to be converted into more plastic state plastic material, rather in some other cases little bit molten state also. Top up side of the diagram 1, you can observe that upper mold half carries the geometry of punch. The punch geometry is equivalent to the internal geometry of the job to be produced. Thus, now the setup, rather the initial stage of compression molding process, is over. After specific period of time, the upper mold half is drawn towards the particularly lower mold half, which you can observe at the second diagram, where the compression and curing of the charge will be carried out. Calculated velocity and force is implied over there for the traveling of upper mold half. Thus, in a compressed condition, particularly the plastic material whichever earlier present in a physical solid state form is converted into the molten state and acquired the exactly mirror replica of the cavity itself. That particularly cavity is thoroughly filled by the molten state plastic material. Obviously, this stage will be carried out, the condition will be carried out for specific period of time. After ensuring the thorough filling of the cavity, the upper mold half is taken back with a specific velocity. And obviously, after opening the mold halves, the removal of finished product is to be carried out. This will be carried out by the knockout pin, which is in referred diagram at the bottom side of the particular part. The knockout pin may be with the numbers available as per the requirement of the job and particular specifications of the job. Thus, in a three stages, the particularly raw material to the finished product, you can very well easily understood with a referred diagrams. Now let us have a look on the two particular diagrams, which are self-explanatory, with which you can easily understood how the parts can be manufactured. Now the first diagram shows the particularly cutaway view of three stages compression molding. In a first diagram, the red colored plastic granules are fed over there, where the guided pins and lower and upper half molds can be visualized very well. The second diagram of the second subset diagram of the first diagram shows that thoroughly closing of the die is there. In the third stage of the first diagram, you can easily observe the exactly mirror replica of the cavity will be achieved by the finished product. Now it has been seen in a red color molded piece. Let us have a look on the second set of diagram, where the tray kind of thing is the final product. Thus, with these two set of diagrams, everyone can understood that how the flow of material will be there in a molded state, and further how the parts can be seen visualized in a finished product sense. Now let us see that particularly which polymers commonly used for the compression molding process. Normally, thermoplastic as well as thermosetting, all the types can be forwarded under the compression molding process. Some of these polymers named as polyester polyamide, polyamide amide, polyphenyl sulfide, polyethylene ether ketone, which is known as PEEK, and also it can be proceed with fiber reinforced plastic. Now all these plastic rather polymer material can be proceed with the various kind of part manufacturing. Let us go with the now advantages of compression molding. Now it has advantages like low initial setup cost, fast setup time. It allows the intricate parts to be produced. It's capable of large size parts and it delivers good surface finish, and relatively a little waste material is there. And one more important thing, it can apply to the composite thermoplastic also. Very few limitations are there. Disadvantages of the compression molding: production speed is not up to the particular type of molding, that is injection molding, and it is limitedly to largely to flat or moderately curved parts with no undercuts. And of course, it doesn't allow the production of hollow parts, rather hollow part design restrictions are there. With these advantages and limitations, now let us proceed with the application of compression molding. Now, are you able to share some of the day-to-day applications of plastic compression molding process? With acquired knowledge from this presentation, just enlist few of them. Now let us see whether your applications are matching with these particular answers. The applications are satellite antenna dishes, circuit breakers, electrical components. It goes with the other specialty application regarding the fuel cell components also. These are the references. Thank you.